Good evening, you're watching Trending Tonight. I'm Sanket Upadhyay. Is India a step closer to Choksi's India Wapsi? We are talking about Mehul Choksi. But you know, in courts outside of this country, he seems to be what appears to be an attempt to delay his departure, that he does not get to fly into India or fly out of where he is. Is there an attempt to deliberately delay that departure, citing health concerns, health reasons? This matter is going on in the court in Dominica. It'll be interesting to see what the outcome is going to be, as this matter is very, very serious. India, obviously the Indian government is hopeful that if it is able to get him back or extradited to India, this will be seen as a big achievement for the government. So is India a step closer to Choksi's India Wapsi, or is there still time? Also on the show, we'll be looking at the Niti Aayog ranking for the Indian states. Let's tell you that Kerala is at the top and Bihar is last. What are the parameters and how have they come to this conclusion? All that and much more later on the show. Let's quickly begin our discussion. We've got Professor Gaurav Vallabh, spokesperson of the Congress Party with us. We also have PKD Nambia, political analyst, views lean towards the Bharatiya Janata Party. In just a short moment, we'll have Mehul Choksi's lawyer as well, Mr. Vijay Agarwal. He's the advocate for Mehul Choksi. And Mr. Vineet Danda, who's filed a petition on this issue in the Supreme Court. Thank you very much, Professor Vallabh. We'll begin with you first. The government is obviously excited because if he comes back, you will be robbed of one point to criticize the government that they let, fugitives of the law go away.
Sanket, it is not 1 point or 2 points scoring. The point here is that 13,000 crore rupees were lost of Indian exchequer. It's the taxpayers' money. Mm. It is your money, my money, your all viewers' money who pays their taxes on time. So 13,000 crore rupees was robbed. That is correct. Now, there are two, three principal questions, and I want answers to these three questions. Number one, he went out of India on January 7, 2018. And January 15, this case came to the limelight. So who gave the leads at that point of time? How come 7-8 days before the case was open in public, he got a leads who were helping him? The country wants to know this, number one. Number two, in last 3 years, because more than 3 years are over, in last 3 years, out of this 13,000 crore, because he's a fugitive, how much money we had recovered in last 3 years, we want to know this. Is it 1 rupee, 1 paisa, or 1 crore, or 100 crore? That is the second point, which we want to know. And the third point, Sanket, that's a broader point. And I want answer from everyone who is watching this show. In last 7 years, 5 lakh crore, 5 trillion rupees of bank fraud had happened. 5 lakh crore. The government of the day talked about the $5 trillion economy, and in last 7 years, we lost 5 trillion rupees in bank frauds. And in last 2 years, Sanket, out of this 5 trillion, 3.25 trillion. In 3.25 trillion means 3,25,000 crore. Banks of our country had lost because of frauds. And all these frauds had happened in the BJP regime, in the Modi government's regime. Who are those people? Who was pressurizing banks to give loans to these type of people?
No, if you allow me, Professor Vallabh, would you like to elaborate on where you're getting these numbers from? Because they appear alarming. And who are these people who are frauding the government?
Sanket, my all data is from the and my all, entire data is from the annual report of Reserve Bank of India, and I will give you source of my all data. When I am saying 5 trillion rupees of bank fraud in last 7 years, I am quoting 2021 annual report of Reserve Bank of India, which was released on the 27th May of last month or 2021. And just to give you one data and to your viewers one data, in last year, that is financial year 2021, all banks in our country had lost 1,38,422 crore because of frauds. In 1920, our all scheduled commercial banks had lost 1,85,000 468 crore because of frauds.
Okay.
And last 7 years total
sure.
is
okay. So
you have
cited the source
rupees.
Of your data of who is responsible for the deceit and also this fraud. Mr. PKD Nambiar, would you want to take or answer any of the questions that have been raised by Professor Gaurav Vallabh? And also, is this a case of you celebrating too soon? You see, what is happening right now is that Mr. Choksi, look at this Antigua cabinet, which is holding a discussion. What are they saying? They are saying Choksi has become Dominica's problem at this time. The truth is, none of these countries want him. He claims that he's not even an Indian citizen. And the reason how that happened, because our Indian government gave the permission to do so, that he can go ahead and become a citizen of another country.
There are two aspects. One is the first one which you said right now, and the second one is the Gaurav Ji's charges.
Yeah.
The first one is that whether the very thing that whether none of these Caribbean countries now wanted to have the Choksi there itself is a victory of the government and the pressure, the kind of pressure this Union government is able to put on these countries to send these people back. We have seen in the case of Vijay Mallya or in the case of Nirav Modi or in this case right now what we are discussing is the Choksi, that this is all gives some kind of a positive sentiment towards an economy wherein nobody can now run away wherever, whichever world they may go and escape, we will try and get them back. That is one of the very, very positive sign at this point of time. Mm-hmm. Now comes to the second part of it. Gauravji was just talking about all the RBI data. The RBI data, what he was quoting is absolutely right. I had an opportunity of looking at that data pretty well. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, it is quoting that data or misrepresenting that data in a different way. The data which clearly says that the most of the money, this is one of the biggest problem. When we say $5 trillion economy, on the other side you say ₹5 trillion. So just confusing the people. Just imagine that on the one side you quote a dollar, on the other side you quote the rupee. That alone will show you that how you wanted to actually manipulate and present it in front of the people. Now come to the number two part, the NPA or the fraudulent part. Where is this? All this money, most of this money has been in the credit goes to the UPA 1 and UPA 2, wherein we always call in Delhi, there is a telephone call, you get a loan. All these NPAs or the fraudulent money has been predominantly committed by during the UPA 1 and 2, wherein there was a system, if you really recall, Sanket, that on the basis of making the economy growing faster, showing the numbers high, the people were distributing money left, right, center without even looking the credibility of the people. That is the reason the people like you and me, as Gauravji said, including Gauravji, the money of all of us, the taxpayers'
okay,
money.
Okay, so that's the political side of the discussion where you're saying that most of these loans were given during the UPA regime. I'll have to give Mr. Professor Vallabh, you'll get an. Yeah, Professor Vallabh, I'll come back to you in just a moment. We also have at this moment Mr. Vijay Agarwal, the advocate for Mehul Choksi, with us. And Mr. Ashwini Dubey, thank you very much, advocate in the Supreme Court, for joining us. Vijay Agarwal, I want to come to you now. Can you explain to us, first of all, the matter of his illegally acquiring the citizenship, which is now a huge subject matter of conversation? And number two, in an earlier broadcast, you were telling me that he's not feeling well, he wouldn't want to he has no issues coming back, but he wants, good treatment and cannot take a long flight back to India. Now, will this or should this not be seen as an attempt to escape the law or delay the inevitable?
See, firstly, you said, brother, that illegally acquiring this citizenship. So I could not understand this term illegally acquiring, because when he acquired this citizenship of Antigua, it is as per the sovereign citizenship by investment program, which is perfectly legal as per the laws in Antigua. There is a separate act, citizenship by investment. One. Two is, when he acquired that citizenship, a report was called from India. And India gave a clean chit that they do not have any objection and they do not want Mr. Mehul Choksi in any criminal case. So I do not understand that how this term illegally acquiring
okay,
is being
sure.
used. So this is it. And now there is a stay from the courts in Antigua about this, that he cannot be extradited to India till the stay is there. So there is no question. And what was your second question? I missed it.
In an earlier broadcast, you said that he wants to go to Miami for treatment. He wouldn't want to take a long flight back to India. Now, this almost sounds like an excuse to escape the law.
See, tell me, how will it sound an excuse? Have you seen his medical reports? Do you know how many bypass surgeries he's gone to? So at times, we want to hear what pleases our ears. And, you know, there is some belief that we have. Oh, this man is an accused. So if he has a medical condition, it has to be an excuse. So there may be a reality also. How can we be so sure? So sure. Neither are you a doctor, nor am I a doctor. And I would not comment on it. I would comment on the medical reports which my client from the doctors provide me. Those reports tell me, and even the bank knew, he has been going for these surgeries to New York earlier, I think from 2014, 15, 13 also he was operated number of times. And you can see the man on your screen. He is a little overweight and he's got a lot of problems. He's 62 plus. So the doctors have given the certificate that he cannot travel.
Okay.
So one may believe, so it may be right, it may not be right. So I don't know how it sounds. So a report has come. So I don't know how it sounds. And from the sound, how can one make that it is a lie?
But you agree that even if he's an Antiguan citizen, legally acquired citizenship, that does not mean that he cannot be extradited to India for crimes committed in the past.
You are 100% right. We need not confuse citizenship with extradition. A person, if he leaves the citizenship of India, that does not mean he's been able to insulate himself from being tried in India. So this citizenship has got nothing to do with it. The only thing is that he's able to stay in that country and he can, and by the rule of law, only after following the due process, which is provided in the Extradition Act, he can be extradited, and which we have challenged in the court.
Ashwini Dubey, let's go to Mr. Dubey also and understand the legal nuances. Mr. Dubey, what are those key things that are unanswered as far as this case is concerned?
Thank you very much, Sanket Bhai, for having me here. I'm not able to understand that why my friend is not talking. My friend, Mr. Vijay Agrawal, is not talking about the citizenship which he acquired on the basis of false, fabricated, manipulated documents, that too by concealment of fact of Antigua. One. Second, the head of the Antigua, a country's head, is stating that you deport him. Third, the magistrate court today has already rejected his bail application that was sought, citing number of precedents that so many people from Antigua, so are the citizens of Antigua, have found in Dominica, and they have been released on bail. That has been rejected. Fourth, the plea of habeas corpus filed by Mr. Mehul Choksi is stating that Mehul Choksi, because as we understand for the Indian constitution, that the plea of habeas corpus can only be filed in a place where person is not traceable. Here is a man who is the guilty of 13,500 crore rupees, which he had cheated to this people of this country. Fourth, as of now, the court has not taken it. Maybe some take it, may take some time, but as per the Extradition Act 1962, the government of India has ample powers even to take somebody who is outside the country with the permission and consent of the country where he is found. I don't know why my friend is not talking about this.
Okay, and let me ask him this question. Mr. Agarwal, he says that the manner in which the citizenship was acquired was illegal through fraudulent means.
See, no, first question is not this. First question is, why am I not talking about it? So you should swap your chairs with him. So let him ask questions, because I am replying to whatever question is being asked. So I did not reply earlier. Not because I don't have an answer.
Okay.
Not
okay.
Because I'm
reply
to
now.
Not because it
Mr.
was
Agarwal,
not asked.
Now that the yes. question is...
Yes.
Now that question is there on the table, please reply.
Yes. There is a notice issued from Antigua to my client that when you acquired this citizenship, you concealed some informations. Mm. There were some informations. That is a 2019 letter. Mm. So why will I not reply? Because I have gone to Antigua and taken a stay on that letter. So that letter is in the court. So that matter is also sub judice. We challenge that letter, that that letter is not in accordance with Section 8 of the Antiguan Citizenship Act. Mm. So that is why there is a stay. So why will I hide from it? Because it is the matter is sub judice in the court.
Mm. Okay. Very quickly, coming back, there are some other points also. We'll come back. We'll circle back to you in just a short moment.
Please.
But Professor Vallabh,
I will answer. I will not skirt anything.
Sure, sure. Absolutely. I know you are absolutely forthcoming with your replies.
Please.
Professor Vallabh, I want to come back to you. You heard Mr. Nambiar, who seemed to suggest that this is actually your problem. These are all loans acquired during UPA 1, UPA 2.
Okay. I will give answer one by one, point by one. Nambiar ji, you mentioned just now in this show only that you had gone through the report. Had you gone through the Reserve Bank report, you might not have asked this type of foolish question. Because as per Reserve Bank of India, the average time lag between the date of occurrence of fraud and the date of detection of fraud was 23 months for 2021 and 24 months for 2019-20. Matlab, 2019-20 se 2 saal pehle wo fraud hue the. Nambiar ji, us samay Modi ji ki aur aapki party ki sarkar thi. 2020-21 से 23 महीने पहले वो बैंकिंग इंडस्ट्री में एंटर हुए थे उस समय आपकी सरकार थी मिस्टर नाम्बियार डोंट शाय अवे डोंट मेक एक्सक्यूज दैट इट इज एक्ट ऑफ गॉड इट इज एक्ट ऑफ प्रीवियस गवर्नमेंट इनफ ऑफ दीज
एक्सक्यूज आई विल कम टू यू मिस्टर
प्लीज नंबर टू पॉइंट यू वर सेइंग 5 लाख करोड़ व्हाट इज 5 लाख करोड़ 5 ट्रिलियन Dollar is different, 5 trillion rupees is different. Mr. Nambiar, are you aware that for 10 years budget of Manrega is 5 lakh crore, Mr. Nambiar? Mr. Nambiar, are you aware that 5 lakh crore is equivalent to giving zero tax to the all taxpayers of our country for 1 year? Mr. Nambiar, are you aware that in 5 lakh crore we can open 500 new aims for our country? These type of oxygen shortage and the people who are dying on the streets of our country, that can be
okay,
stopped.
Fair enough. Quick right to reply to Mr. Nambiar.
It's not a small thing.
Mr. Nambiar, quick right to reply, please.
Firstly, from the last point what he said, that is the reason 5 lakh crore rupees, what you are mentioning, that is the reason in 60 years of you being in power, you could not make more than 2 aims. You were talking about the price.
You
secondly,
really
why are you...
To my no, no.
I am going to tell you what I want.
Don't shy away. We will not allow you to move like this. You have to accept
let's talk one by
what
one
had
fact.
Happened in
first,
your
one by one, please.
Who were the people who were facilitating these okay, frauds? You can't move out of this. I am going to take an answer for my question that why time lag is 24 months before 24 months there was a Modi government.
Professor Vallabh, our viewers will not make sense like this. Mr. PKD Nambiar, do you get the time period wrong? Professor Vallabh says that the time period mentioned here as far as these frauds are concerned were during the
Modi's regime. No. Please check the fact. When the 13,500 crore was not given to any of these people, whether it is in the case of Vijay Mallya, whether it is in the case of Mehul Choksi, it's all there in the public domain. Are we talking about all these stuff in the last 1 or 2 years? No, come on, man. This is not something which is happening. This is all about corrupt practices. Why Congress...
You are not trying to answer me. I am giving
you a quote from RBI
annual report.
This is a discussion on the sidelines. Very quickly coming back. Mr. Dubey, you tell me...
The
basic question, Mr. Dubey, I'll come to you, Mr. Nambiar. The basic question over here is that how soon can he be extradited? How many steps are left as far as his deportation is concerned? Where are we as far as
yes,
this process is concerned?
Yes, Sanket Bhai.
Obviously, there'll be an attempt to delay the inevitable. I mean, Mr. Agarwal will not agree, but the point is we all are aware of the great Indian chest pain that every politician has whenever he has to go to jail.
Yes, Sanket Bhai, very true. Very, very valid question you have asked. As of now, let me tell you very frankly, very clearly and very honest opinion. As of now, India is not a party to the proceedings which are pending in the Dominica. So if Indian government wants him deportation to India, then Indian government has to file a separate plea through Dominican prosecutors. Point one. Second, so far as the habeas corpus petition filed by Mr. Chokshi's attorney, that to my friend Mr. Vijay Agrawal, seeking answer from Dominica on the circumstances under which the fugitive reached there, was found in the country on May 23, has been answered by the President of Antigua. President of Antigua what says? That we don't want to take back. So the person who is citizen of Antigua and the head of that country says, no, we don't want him. Just deport him back to India because he's India's criminal. So under those circumstances, third, so far as the legal point is concerned, as we discussed on NDTV Hindi, Sanket Bhai, that Rule 3, Section 3 of Extradition Act 1962, clearly says that notification may also be issued by the government, Indian government, to the country where the person who is deported to be sought to this
sure,
country.
Sure, okay.
Is
then, Mr. Off. Vijay Agarwal, we come back to the main point. Given all these facts, the fact that his country of which he holds the citizenship is not willing to take him back, are we to assume that this is yet another case where Mr. Mehul Chokshi finds himself in a tricky spot and thus wants to delay the inevitable?
I am not the guest. My client is not the guest of the Antiguan government that they will open the door or not the door. I have the constitutional protection. So if a particular government says something, particular politician says something, it is meaningless. So they may say that a person is welcome or the person is not welcome. That is meaningless. We have a court order in our favor. We are the, see, at this moment, Mr. Mehul Chokshi is a citizen of Antigua. And it is
can,
not
can
a
Can I right. tell you, can I, Mr. Agarwal, can I please quote what the Antigua cabinet says? They say, preference of cabinet of Antigua is for Mr. Chokshi to be repatriated to India from Dominica.
So that's their preference. And I'm sorry, they will not get what they prefer. We may prefer a lot of things in life, but we may not get whatever we wish. So Mr. Chokshi's citizenship is a writing on the wall. It is not written on some blackboard with a chalk that a cabinet feels that it can wipe it off with a duster.
Mr. Agarwal, so, was he abducted?
And it can be removed only by the court process, which they started, on which there is a stay. So now all these are talks to please people here for the political motive. It has got no legal.
Mr. Agarwal, how did he reach? How did he reach Dominica?
Yes, my client
abducted.
My client reached Dominica not voluntarily. He was trapped. And he was called into a house by a lady known to him, where many people pounced on him and they bundled him up and they put him on a boat. Then they changed boats and then he was taken to the island. And my instructions are that there were coast guard, there were police, the whole machinery was against him.
Okay, I'm going to leave it here because
let
it's
me
a,
me complete.
Yeah, sure. Brother. Sure, Mr. Agarwal.
So, but, and the moment he did not return home, a hue and cry was raised. And Antiguan police, let me tell you, I must praise Antiguan police because the family was very, very happy with the effort they had put in. They issued the yellow notice. They sent dog squad. They sent CID. They sent everyone. And ultimately, because of this hue and cry raised, they had to admit that the man is there. And let's be very clear. They knew that he's there since 24th. They revealed to the world on 27, 28.
Okay. It's a weird situation. Thank you very much, guys. The weird situation is that he finds himself in a situation where no one's willing to accept him. His country, of which he has citizenship right now, is in an official note of the cabinet says that there is a preference that he be repatriated to India. How far is he from facing the law here in this country is the big question. Very quickly, let's put out those graphics on the Niti Aayog ranking for Indian states. Now, this, of course, is the sustainable development goals of the Niti Aayog. Kerala retains the top rank, according to the Niti Aayog. Bihar has been adjudged the worst performer. Both Himachal Pradesh and Tamil Nadu took the second spot with a score of 74. These are important rankings on developmental goals. This Bihar, Jharkhand, Assam are actually the worst performing state in this year's India index. So it's even Assam, a BJP ruled Assam. Index actually evaluates the progress of states, UTs on social, economic and environmental terms, like a complete sustainable development goal. South states have dominated the top five. North are the lowest five. So the top five are all South Indian states, by the way. Notable improvement has taken place, says this report, from 2019-2020. There is, according to them, great improvement. Niti Aayog has released the sustainable development goal ranks. At 66, India score is up from 60 in 1920. So that's this report that we wanted to bring to all our viewers. That's a wrap in this edition of Trending Tonight. News continues on the other side. Stay with us.